Hi, this is Girish Shende, and as you know that I have already uploaded some videos regarding cost sheets. I have also uploaded the videos of tender and quotations, which are very important from the point of view of the syllabus from BCom, BBA, BCCA. Today I am going to explain you about the tender once again. Now this problem is very different from what I have stated the problem before. So remain with me unless you understand the whole problem. Otherwise you will not able to understand the whole problem. So here I'll let you know the reverse condition in this problem also. So how to solve this problem, how to understand those information and how it should be calculated. So each term you have to pay attention. So remain with me till I finish this video. Now I have given some information on the board regarding the question for tender or quotation. So here we have to find out the gross profit and net profit. Some information is given here. So what is that information? We'll see. This is number of units produced. So what we have to prepare with first see that. Find out gross profit and net profit as per cost book from the following. So the following information is given. We'll see that what information is given here. Number of units produced is 2000 units, whatever the period it is, right? Now the cost of production is 300 rupees per unit. Then the selling price is rupees 400 per unit. Then selling overheads or selling expenses is 25 rupees per unit. Then we have opening stock of finished goods. It is nil because opening stock, whatever the previous closing stock, it was not there. So here opening stock is not given here. It is nil. Then we have closing stock of finished goods. When we sell the goods, of course the stock which remains with us, it is called closing stock. So opening stock is not given. Only closing stock of finished goods is given. It is in units, that is 200 units. Now from this information we will solve the problem. Now here I have drawn a format of the solution which we have gone through the information given in the problem. So as per the cost sheet, as per the pro forma of the cost sheet, we have to assign the cost unit. And we have to write the unit column, then amount is here, second column, and the third column is made up of unit, per unit. Then we have to write the cost of production. Already cost of production is given. Cost of production is 300 rupees per unit. And how many goods are produced, units are produced? 2000 units are produced, we have seen there. So here 2000 units are produced and the cost of production of that unit per unit is 300 rupees. So multiplying 2000 with 300 units, I have already written here, per unit is 300 and there are 2000 units produced during that period. So multiplying the units per unit with the units produced, it will give you 6 lakhs. 2, 3 are 6 lakhs. Okay. So here we have got the cost of production. The what comes next? So opening stock. Opening stock of, as per our format, we are writing the opening stock. So opening stock is not given here. Opening stock of finished goods is nil. So we will not write opening stock of finished goods amount and the units also. Only we have to write add. So remember, whenever you are solving any problem, you can sketch a format and according to the format, it may or may not be given that amount. So you have to take into consideration in cost of production what you have to add. So opening stock of finished goods is added. It is a format. And closing stock of finished goods is subtracted. So you have to remember here. Now we get the same amount when we add opening stock, it is nil, and we add in cost of production, 6 lakhs become the same amount. Then here unit is also here, the same amount is there. Now we have to deduct the closing stock as per the format of the cost sheet. So closing stock of finished goods is given, it is 200 units. Closing stock is given 200 units and the same actually whatever the cost of production will have the rate of per unit, the same rate will have on the closing stock also. So whatever the goods are manufactured and what cost it has come finally, so it is 300 rupees per unit. So the cost of closing stock per unit will be the same here, because the cost of production here it is 300 rupees per unit. So then we have that when we subtract closing stock of finished goods from the cost of production and opening stock of finished goods, then we get the cost of goods sold. As per the format of the cost sheet, we get when we subtract closing stock of finished goods from this amount, then we get cost of goods sold. It is also said as COGS in short form. Then we have got cost of goods sold, that is deducting 200 unit, it is closing stock, from the units produced, we get 1800 units. Here, the 1800 units are cost of goods sold. So, these 1800 units becomes the cost of goods sold. Then, we can have the same actually rate. What we have deducted 60,000. 200 unit, it was finished good, and multiplying by the cost of production rate per unit, we got 60,000. So, deducting 60,000 from 6 lakhs, we get 5,40,000, and the same unit will have on the cost of goods sold also. Because for whatever the units produced per unit rate, it will also levy on the same, same rate will be levied on the cost of goods sold. Now here, the sale is given here. Selling price is 400 rupees per unit is given. And how much unit we are selling? We are selling 1800 units. So we are selling 1800 units and sale is given here. So we are selling at the cost of 400 rupees per unit. So 1800 multiplied by 400, it becomes 7,20,000. Now we don't have this gross profit. We have sales and we have to deduct from sale cost of goods sold. So there is a formula. Sales minus COGS, or you can say sales minus cost of goods sold, it will give you gross profit. You can also find out the cost of goods sold when you deduct gross profit from sales. If you deduct sales minus GP, gross profit, it will give you cost of goods sold. So there is a relation between the cost of goods sold, gross profit and sales. Whenever you add gross profit in cost of goods sold, you get sales only. So this equation is very important in every type of problem. So here we are getting, if we deduct this cost of goods sold from sales, we are getting gross profit. Gross profit in terms of units, the same in number of units we are selling, and it will be a, because dividing 180,000 by 1800, you get 100 rupees per unit. So the gross profit is 100 rupees per unit you sold, that is 1800 unit. Then here we got the gross profit. Now in the problem, it is given that you have to find out the gross profit. We have find out the gross profit now. Now net profit also we have to find out. So for net profit, we have to compute the different table. What we have to do? We have to just subtract the selling and distribution expenses from gross profit. So it will give you net profit. So it is very easy. So I have written here statement showing net profit. Now what was the gross profit? It is already we have found out. So the same gross profit will be written here in units, in amount and per unit also. Then we have selling and distribution. So selling overheads are given 25 rupees per unit already. So we have sold 1800 units. The same 1800 units will be multiplied by 25 rupees. So here I have written 25 rupees per unit, and 1800 units we have sold, and multiplying the 25 rupees by 1800, we get 45,000. Deducting 45,000 from gross profit amount, you get net profit. So we have got 1,35,000 as a net profit. And the unit sold, we have sold the units 1,800 only. So in this column, you write every, in every line, you write 1,800. So on 1,800 unit, you have got the gross profit also. On 1,800 units only, you have got the net profit also. So here we have got on 1,800 unit, its net profit is 1,35,000. And if you divide 1,35,000 by 1,800 units, what you have sold, you get the unit per rate, that is net profit per unit. So here, deducting from 100 unit, 25 rupees. So it was, gross profit unit was 100 rupees per unit. And the selling and distribution expenses were 25 rupees per unit. So deducting from gross profit unit, selling and distribution expenses unit, you get 75. So here you get 75 rupees as a net profit per unit according to the sums. So this is very important for the from the point of view of the exams, and it is also useful to CA, ICWA and CS also. So I'll let you know some other sums also. First we will understand here, if we go reverse, what will happen? So if you are not given the cost of production here, and you are given all this information, net profit, gross profit, and cost of goods sold is also given. So by adding the selling and distribution expenses in net profit, you get gross profit. In gross profit, you have to add the cost of goods sold. If you add cost of goods sold in gross profit, you get the sales. Now here, you have to add the closing stock. We have closing stock of finished goods, we have deducted. While going reverse, you have to add closing stock of finished goods and subtract the opening stock of finished goods. Then you will get the cost of production. So I'll let you know in upcoming videos, I'll let you know about the reverse condition of this statement of showing gross profit and net profit. So remain with me, and you please press the bell icon to see my next videos. I'll let you know more about these problems and the problems which are very critical in calculations. I'll let you know. And you can also subscribe my channel, and you can send the comments also here, and you can also write the opinions about my videos. Thank you very much.